The U.S. Postal Service admits it's hemorrhaging money, losing a staggering $25 million a day. Through the end of March alone, the USPS lost $3.2 billion. Now, the agency has called for legislative change to stop the bleeding, and the Senate passed a bipartisan postal reform bill at the end of April, but the House has still to act. I'm joined now by Delaware Democratic Senator Tom Carper, who's one of the sponsors of the Senate Postal Reform Bill. Good to see you, Senator. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Chris. Good morning.
You want the House to pass this postal reform immediately. In fact, you've launched a website, and it's got a very eye-catching ticker that actually tracks the Postal Service's losses to the dollar since the Senate passed its bill in April. What do you think that might accomplish?
We hope it gets the House get off its duff. They passed a bill out of committee, a postal reform bill out of committee, about 6 months ago. During that period of time, we've introduced bipartisan legislation, voted on it, debated it, marked it up in the committee, voted on it, debated on it, passed it in the Senate. Now we're waiting for the House to act. There every day the delay, the Postal Service is losing about $25 million. They already owe about $13 billion to the Treasury. And this is a situation can be fixed. This is not an insolvable problem. This one can be fixed. It's a situation serious, but it can be fixed. We just need for the House, rather than just complaining and criticizing what we've done in the Senate, pass your bill.
Well, Congressman Daryl Issa proposed a bill that would end Saturday delivery within 6 months, which President Obama supports for $3 billion in annual savings. The Senate bill has been criticized for continuing Saturday delivery for at least a couple more years. So why keep Saturday service going? What's the idea behind that?
Well, as it turns out, there's really only one enterprise in the country that has in every community, goes to every door in the country five, six times a week. And it's a very, potentially, I think, a very successful, lucrative business enterprise. And we don't say, you know, you got to continue to maintain six-day delivery forever. We say we've got all these ways to save money that we've included in our bill. Hopefully the House will have a lot of good ideas as well. And let's just allow the Postal Service to pursue those different ways to cut spending, reduce spending, to be able to raise revenues. And if 2 years from now that hasn't done the job, then they are free to go ahead and go to five-day-a-week service.
Well, Congressman Issa's bill would also reform the Postal Service's collective bargaining process. Current union contracts include no layoff clauses. They also have these rubber rooms where idled employees are paid essentially to do nothing. Does your bill address these kinds of practices, and should it?
Oh, yes, it certainly does. The Postal Service finds itself in a little bit the same place that the auto industry was here in this country a couple of years ago. U.S. auto industry had more employees than they needed. They had more plants, more supply. They wanted an investment by the U.S. taxpayers. The Postal Service is not asking for a bailout here. They'd like to be reimbursed the $11 billion they've overpaid into the federal employee retirement system. They'd like to be able to use some of that money to help encourage 100,000 postal employees who are eligible to retire to retire. They'd like to pay off most of their debt to the Treasury, most of that $13 billion. And they want to say about 13 out of the 33,000 post offices across the country, they'd like to say to about for 13,000 of them, we're going to change the business model, not close your post office, but in the future, we'll have not a postmaster making $50,000, $60,000, $70,000 running that post office. We want to have a contract employee there working maybe 15 hours a day for 2, 4, 6 hours a day. That alone saves about $500 million. The Postal Service wants to reduce by a third their mail processing centers. That will save a lot of money as well. And we change the arbitration guidelines so that arbitrators who are working in wage benefit negotiations between the unions and the post office have to consider among the factors the financial condition of the post office. They don't have to do that now.
Delaware Senator Tom Carper, keep us posted. Thank you so much.
Thank you. That's good. Thank you. I will.